In the news today, from the strange desires that the
so damn disrespectable.
Testifying earlier today, comedian George Lopez arriving here at the courthouse as only a Hollywood celebrity can. Lopez called as a prosecution witness. He testified today that he met the accuser in 1999 at a comedy camp and he befriended the young boy. He said that when the accuser fell sick with cancer, he did go to see him at the hospital, and Lopez said that it was actually the boy's father who repeatedly asked for money, rather, and not the boy's mother. Now, this testimony supports prosecution testimony earlier last week from comedian Louise Palenker, who said the same thing. Judge Rodney Melville saying the prosecution can call witnesses and introduce evidence related to prior allegations against Michael Jackson, a ruling some legal experts say may hurt the defense.
This is now a trial about pattern evidence, about propensity, and once a pedophile, always a pedophile.
The jury will hear testimony from one alleged victim who the prosecution says was molested by Jackson in 1990. That accuser settled with Jackson for $2.4 million and that no charges were ever filed.
The ruling that could make or break the case against Michael Jackson has been handed down. Jurors will hear about prior allegations of abuse by Michael Jackson. Testimony about five other incidents, fair game, will come from a handful of witnesses, including a number of former Neverland employees and one of the prior accusers who was paid millions for his silence back in the 1990s.
You know, this was a big ruling. You could tell because it got really personal and intense in the arguments before Judge Melville. At one point, Tom Mesereau, whom you just heard from, Jackson's lead attorney, saying the prosecution is desperate, that their case is weak, it's bad, and it's getting worse. And Tom Snedden, the prosecutor, answering back that Mesereau himself was obnoxious, abusive, mean-spirited in his questioning of the accuser in this case. Well, you call it a handful of witnesses. It is exactly that, Dan. Nine in number. That 1990 accuser to whom you referred, his mother, and the mother of the 1993 accuser, and then people, Charlie Michaels, who's a female security guard from that 93 case, Philip Lamarck, a chef at Neverland in 93, Adrian McManus, who's a maid, and Ralph Chacon, a security guard, the two of them involved in a suit against Jackson, which they lost. Bob Jones, who worked for MJJ Productions for a number of years, writing a book, and Charmaine Sternberg, who worked for MJJ Productions and was a gift coordinator. But here's the thing. I talked to Jim Rogan last week, the former California assemblyman who authored the bill allowing this old evidence in, and he said this could be a case to be careful what you wish for the prosecution. Many of them sold their stories to supermarket tabloids and tabloid television. Two, as I mentioned, were involved in a losing lawsuit against Jackson. Others, Bob Jones writing a book. Others have changed their stories demonstrably, and you know that Tom Mesereau, as he said in court today, is going to conduct full-blown trials if it comes to that, to try and impeach every one of these stories.
I was still waiting for some accuser to actually want to testify in this case, and still we're not getting any. I think the prosecution
getting one of them.
Is going to be in for a
You're getting the 1990
well,
accuser.
Six.
It's going to be another kid who's going to come into that courtroom, now an adult, and say, yeah, Michael Jackson molested me, and that's why he paid X amount of dollars to me.
That kid was interviewed by Lauren Weiss, who's a district attorney, and she didn't think a crime had been committed, and neither did the Santa Barbara sheriffs when they interviewed him. And nobody filed any charges at that time, and I think that it's going to be very suspect 15 years after the fact coming into court.
That is not necessarily the death knell for Michael Jackson in this case, because each one of these witnesses will have their own credibility problems. What is the motive here? What's the interest here? And it very well may be that this could be very helpful in the long run to show how desperate the prosecution case really is.
But now they're going to hear a parade of other people saying it happened to me, it happened to me, it happened to me.
I think it's remote. It's very remote in time.
There's never been a case, Susan, and you know this, in history of California jurisprudence where you've had five people accusing someone else of molestation, but those five don't show up. And what is Tom Senna going to say when that child actor, and we all know who it is, gets on the stand and says, those witnesses of yours were lying? That's going to be a problem.
Some people are going to say that they witnessed abuse. There are going to be others, you know, one kid who's going to, now an adult who's going to come in. I got to tell you, I think some of the witnesses could be even more powerful because they didn't get the money.
On the stand right now, Allison, as you mentioned, Jamie Masada. He runs a comedy club in Los Angeles, The Laugh Factory, and eventually put the boy in touch with Michael Jackson. Before Masada was placed under the gag order, he told NBC's Dateline that he received a phone call from the boy's mother. She was very upset, and she said, everybody's listening to me, and I can't leave Neverland.
It was Masada who helped the boy meet Jackson in 2000. The boy gets cancer. You make an arrangement so that he gets to meet, because he wants to meet Michael Jackson. You talked about Michael Jackson suffering. You saw him in court.
I saw him for the first time in a while.
One of his kidney.
Jamie Masada, he's the comedy club owner who first introduced Michael Jackson to his teenage accuser. Mr. Masada, thanks for coming in. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
You introduced the two people.
Kid have a cancer, had a kidney taken off.
Yeah.
But can you tell us briefly how well you know Michael?
I do not know Michael at all, but I know the family and the kids very well because he needs blood, because his blood is very, very rare. His blood is O negative, CMV negative.
Because it's, no, my impression no, 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 has no. been throughout that you personally knew Michael Jackson and made this introduction. Are you saying now that's not the story?
No, it was not like that at all. I do not know Michael at all.
So you've never met Michael Jackson?
I never met Michael Jackson.
Do you think your story would have quite the same punch if people knew that, Jamie, that you never knew, met Michael Jackson, that this is all secondhand?
Because
in my conversation with Michael Jackson today and with his new publicist, Raymond Bain, they told me that he doesn't know who you are, doesn't know you, never met you, and that, in fact, it was Vinay Watson-Johnson from the old Fresh Prince of Bel-Air series, the actress, who introduced him through the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
No, it was not.
Is that true?
It's not true.
But they told me you had nothing to do with meeting the victim. Michael Jackson doesn't know anything about you.
I can't make any comment on that. He can say what he wants. Well, the most important thing is the kid was dying. I introduced him to Rob Schneider, to Adam Sandler, took him under the wing to the studio, took him to lunch, gave him Chris Tucker, took him shopping.
I applaud any action like that. What I deplore, though, are people who pretend to know Michael Jackson when they really don't.
I never said I know Michael Jackson.
Right. But if people say you introduced him to Michael Jackson, Jamie, you admit that that is not true. That is a lie.
I spoke to a gentleman in Neverland.
What's his name? What's his
name?
Who did you speak to?
I don't have the name in front of me. Okay. Why are you questioning all of that?
Well, I'm questioning it because you've been making a lot of hay for the last several months as the man who quote unquote introduced Michael Jackson to the kid who later accused him of molestation, and that's not true.
Like you, I spoke with Mr. Jackson earlier today at length. He has no idea who this guy is. You have outed this guy like many others who are running around here speaking in the name of Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson is just sick and tired of people running around speaking in his name and telling untruths. And this Jamie Masada does not know Michael Jackson. That's why he's struggling with you on the air, because he knows that you've outed him, and the media is willing to give people like Masada credibility because they assume he's close to Michael Jackson.
I don't know, Geraldo, where you got your information, and I don't know what you're
from
doing
Michael
here.
Jackson
no
and
idea.
The people around him.
Let me explain something here. This is a kid. We all, comedian, everybody helped him. He need a kidney. He's there. He have O negative. He's CMV negative. That's the reason I came on the show. Go ahead, do whatever you want to do.
It's not about the kids. It's about you, Jamie. That's good. Okay, thank you, Jamie.
About me, I'm doing.
Thank you.
Yes.
Good night. Thank you, Jamie. Thank you. I got it.